Okay, there's an error on this SAID test, but it says it requires work in Valgrind, which we wouldn't have in this environment. So I'm not sure why that has been not mentioned. Oh no, actually it's referring to that test, which it skipped. In place configure header not defined. Now that's an SE Linux script, looks like. It could be there's something in the kernel or something, yeah, not in the kernel that that needs. So I'm not too concerned about that. I'll carry on. What we'll do is I'll rerun the tests. Yeah, it's coming up again, and I'll rerun them again, but this time I'm just going to specify one job in case the fact that we're running or we have the parallel. No, that's not an option. Sorry, I put that in the wrong place. It should be here. In case make is using many threads, because we've got that environment variable set. Yeah, it's suddenly running a little bit slower. No, it's still happening. Like I said, I'm not really worried about that. That's something I think I can ignore safely. So I'll just go ahead and install the package. So I've just noticed as I started this test that it does specifically say that you can force make check to run with the number of cores by specifying this variable here, test suite flags equals minus J24 in my case. Just set that to whatever you've got make flags set to. Sorry, it says append it. Make check. So just copy this. Put 24 in. So yes, it's running a lot quicker. So again, it looks like one of the tests has failed. Let's see which one it is. Oh, right, okay, so I know why this is. It's because I haven't got IPv6 running. That looks like what that's trying to use. So I'm happy with that. Of course, if this was an installation I wanted to make sure it was perfect for day-to-day use, then I would make sure that that was in the kernel so that, that test would pass. But other than that, that's not a problem. Unless you know you've got that disabled, I wouldn't expect that you would see that at all. So I'll just go ahead and install the Perl package. Right, those tests got a failure, but that failure is account before. I saw it as it went past, as it says in here that test suboptsh fails, is known to fail. It's probably quicker for me to just scroll back if the scroll is large enough. Yep, there it is there. So that's all good. So I'll run make install, and that's auto make done. Now if you remember, after auto make, libtool needed to be reinstalled and retested, so I'm going to do that now. So make check and use this test flags, test suite flags option again to speed up the tests. And with any luck this time, we won't see those five failures at the end. Yep, that's finished. We've got no red come up. It says 138 behaved as expected, 32 were skipped. So we know that's a good build. So I'm going to rerun the make install and use this build because I know it's good. Rerun that remove. And that's the libtool rebuild done. So I'll get rid of that. We've just still got this ACL to rebuild after call utils has been built. So I'm now just going to carry on with the book until I get to core utils, where I'll go back and do ACL. So again, with this, it says not to run the test because some hang and to do the testing at the end of this chapter. So it's basically when the complete system's been installed. I'm not sure what those warnings are. I think I've seen them before. They're not mentioned in the book. But there are any warnings, so it's not anything to worry about in particular. As I'm pretty sure I've seen them before. So there's documentation I've installed. And the next two packages, as it says here, not strictly required because we're not using systemd, but it's handy to have. They'll be needed for several packages in the BLFS book anyway. So I'll install them anyway. So once again, core utils has been installed. Just remembered I didn't leave Python here, so I'm going to duplicate that tab. Go back to core utils. Now I've done that, I can rebuild ACL and run the tests properly. So I should do that now. So rebuilding this or rerun the configure. Rebuild it. And now I can run make check. And you can see that's passed completely this time. So I'll just do make install. That's complete. And remove the ACL. Get rid of the tab and carry on with the remaining packages. So a decision needs to be made here about setting this paper size variable for the UK and probably Europe, most of Europe as well. Default would be A4 size. US would probably be letter. I don't know if there's any other options, but if you do get the wrong setting, you find then it can be overridden, as it says here, by writing the correct value to etc paper size. It does mention in the book about UEFI support. I have done that on previous builds of Linux from scratch. I'm not going to do it this time because, again, it's not a default part of the book. I don't know whether it ever will be or not, but currently it just refers you to the BLFS page, so that's an optional thing, and being it's not part of the default build, if you like the standard build, I won't be doing it this time. As I say, I've done it in previous videos, so I think I did it in the previous version 11.0, so if you wish to follow that, how to do that, then by all means look at that video. But otherwise I'm going to carry on and just do a normal grub without UEFI support. Okay, there's one failure there. It does say there's one expected failure. Binary store restore. So let's just look for that. Yeah, there it is. So that's okay. So I'll just carry on and install the package. And carry on with the remaining packages. So I think I should explain that what I've done there is just search for string all done in the log. As it says there, a successful test result in those words. So if that wasn't successful, then nothing would have appeared here. So the fact that all done has appeared indicates that the test was successful. Well, as you saw there, there was five failures. It does say that these ones to do with p-kill, these five here are known to fail anyway due to a problem. So there's no other failures, so that test is good. So I'll just go ahead and install the package. So that's the end of the packages that need to be installed, apart from the kernel, which is in a separate chapter. There's a bit here about debugging symbols, and basically how we can get rid of unnecessary debugging information that's in some of the binaries we've created. Does say it's needed if you're running regression tests that use Valgrind or GDB later in BLFS. It's something I've never thought of. I've sometimes installed Valgrind and then gone ahead after stripping this debugging information, running Valgrind in BLFS. There's obviously a reason why some tests have failed, so that's something I have to bear in mind. So likewise yourself, if it's something you think you might want to do, is build BLFS and build Valgrind for fuller coverage of tests that you might want to not do this. Otherwise, this will save some disk space if you run these commands. So I really should have done a DF at the beginning to find out how much space we've saved. It would have been quite a bit, but we've used just 1.6 gig, and that includes about 0.4 gig of source files. So as you can see, the Linux Scratch base system is quite tiny. So there's a few more things that it can be cleaned up here. This might save a little bit more space. Finally, we'll delete the tester user. In fact, do we need it for Python? No, it doesn't look like we do, so I'll do that out. So we move on to the next part, which is system configuration. But before we do that, I'm going to rebuild Python. Let's do df-h. It's saved another 100 megabytes doing that last bit, cleaning up the odd files here and there. So you see I'll need to go back to sources, extract Python. In fact, I should maybe have done this before those stripping commands, so maybe I won't install this, possibly. Maybe I will. I should do, really, because assuming the test pass, it's the only confidence I've got that I've got a Python that's installed that's passed the tests. So I'll run the test now with make test. Okay, so there was some bug. Is there one failure? Full test failed again. So I'm not sure what these are about. I mean, it does mention test SQLite there. Oh, they skipped. Failed test curses. Yeah, I'm not really sure about the other one. We have got ncurses installed. But it does say it's not recommended at this point. I would probably tend to prefer, given the results, to rerun the test in BLFS maybe. They still don't seem to be completely free of problems even at this point, even when it says they can be rerun at the end of this chapter. The account for these, and there's no mention that there may be failures anyway. So I think I'm going to just ignore that and just use the Python that I've already got. And what I'll do is just close that down, and in the next video I'll be carrying on to configure the system, making Linux from scratch bootable, and then finally copying this image back to the USB stick and attempting to boot from it.